Okay. I think a lot of stories are talking about sacrifice. Soldiers and pilots defending their countries and giving their souls bravely. A lot of books are talking about this, historical books, political books, books about war, literature, poetry, and immunology. Have you ever heard an immunological sacrifice story? Okay, neutrophils, the major class of white blood cells in your body, the real soldiers defending you all the time against types of infections like bacteria. Neutrophils, like any other cell in your body, must contain a genetic material inside, very long strands of the DNA compacted in the form of chromosomes. They are also called the granulocytes because of containing bactericidal granules that can kill the bacteria. And that's why we say that neutrophils can fight the infection by one of two ways: swallowing the bacteria to kill them by granules inside, or releasing the granules to kill the bacteria but outside. That was until 2004, when Brinkman discovered a new weird way of defense. Some neutrophils could sacrifice their lives just to save us during the infection, on the war, inside your body. Some neutrophils bring the chromosomes out of the nucleus, decompact the strands of the DNA to form a very heavy, complicated net filled with these granules, something like a trap. And suddenly, in the exact time, the outer wall of the cell starts to rupture in a very dramatic scene. It looks like the cell decided to end its life just to release this net outside to cover the broadest spectrum around, trap the infection, localize it, and finally kill the bacteria using these granules. Neutrophil extracellular trap. This is the name, abbreviated as NET. And to be more accurate, it's a suicidal net, as it ends by suicide or death of the cell. And that's what made Steinberg in 2007 to add a new expression about cell death physiology. He said, in this case, neutrophils don't die normally by apoptosis. They are not killed too by necrosis. They are dying for a reason, to release this net outside. So we have to call this netosis. Netosis becomes a very important expression in immunology today, especially when we found the relationship between the exaggerated formation of these nets and the incidence of autoimmune disorders like lupus erythematosus, rheumatoid arthritis, and so. That will open new doors to diagnose and monitor these disorders just by measuring the levels of these nets in the patient's blood. Let's change our minds. Cells have stories just like ours. Netosis was a sacrifice story, a real sensation of honor and safety. We have cells that do never mind to die just to keep us alive. Thank you.